What's up, friends? I'm Sophie. It's Tuesday and it's day 7 of the Thought Challenge. And I really just keep thinking about THOT thoughts. Maybe I need to come up with a better title for this. We'll come back to that. But I have been thinking a lot about your truth and your timeline and like honesty within the feed. So I am all for curating your feed. And I don't super love using the word curate because it makes it sound really pretentious, but that's what I do. I put a lot of thought and effort into what I post online, which seems sort of superficial, but in the day and age that we're in, especially someone who wants to enter the public eye, is in the digital sphere, like what you post online is your brand. That is your content. That says who you are. And I know people who have gone back in their timelines to delete pictures that didn't get enough likes or they didn't like what it looked like. And I have deleted pictures, guilty, sentence me, charge me, like whatever. But I have friends who have gone back to the beginning of their timeline, to the beginning of their Instagram or whatever, and they've deleted mass amounts of posts. And I'm not judging you if you do that, but I don't think it's for me, because as someone who is entering the public view, I don't want someone to go to my timeline, to go there, to look through the whole thing. Like, if you're looking through the whole thing, by the way, praise be, amen, you have put yourself through a very fine task. But I don't want someone to go and then like see that from day one, I'm getting 40 plus likes on something, which 40 likes doesn't seem like a lot. But when I first started Instagram, which was in 2012, oh God, getting 2 likes on something was like, you know? So I don't want that. I don't want, not, I'm not saying you're a liar, because that's not even close to what it is. And you're allowed to curate and you're allowed to pick and choose what you want. But I kind of like that honesty. Like, I like that it's a true timeline of my journey, whether the journey be Instagram or my self journey or Facebook or whatever. Like, I want there to be a truth. I want there to be tangible history. And I don't want to appear like from the get-go that I was like amazing, because I'm not even close. Oh, I just like scratched my chin. But I need to feel honest in this conversation and then to feel like I am doing what I set out to do. I can't go back and delete, because that's like saying who I was back then isn't valid. And she's so valid. Like, little Sophie, she went through a fucking lot of shit. Like, she deserves to exist. And if the way she exists is by being bad photos on my Instagram timeline, then that's her place. Because I'm not perfect and I don't want to appear perfect. And if somebody doesn't like that when I was 18 years old, 17 years old, I posted a picture of a burger, which I don't know if I've actually ever done, but if I have done it, like, don't fucking judge me. Like, what were you doing on Instagram 6 years ago? Food. Everyone was doing food on Instagram 6 years ago, so back the fuck off. So I just want to say that to anyone who feels like they need to hide who they used to be or change what their online persona seems to be, I'm not saying you don't have to, and if you feel like you do, then go for it, do it. But just also know that there are people like myself who appreciate the truth in your timeline, who find it very admirable, actually, to keep it, because you're saying that by today's standards, even though I failed, I'm still holding myself up high. And I think that that's really magical. And so, yeah, here's to truth in your timeline. Comment below. Tell me how you keep your truth alive in your timeline in this digital sphere. What do you do to make sure that your online brand, your content, is representative of you? It's Tuesday, it's the Thought Challenge, and I'm Sophie. Bye, friends.